The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there. She keeps going towards.
He's always.
Where are you watching you?
The beast is there. You're never safe from him.
You can feel him.
Be careful.
She needs to find Ilya.
She's
found it. She lost it and she has to fight it.
I can feel it.
Okay.
you wouldn't listen.
He was doing his best.
She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right.
Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She never choose.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn? Where will she learn?
She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find it.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all the world. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the fire.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe.
What's happening?
What's she thinking?
How's she going to get there? There's light on the other side.
She can do it. Come out. She can make it.
She can't get through. She has to.
Get up. Get up.
What are you doing? Can't help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Lose it now.
He's going too slow.
It's so close.
The torch will go out.
Yeah.